At Apex Vaulting, we recently posted on Instagram, Facebook, and Twitter about fixing the collapsed bottom arm. The first step to fixing it is deciding what is creating the collapsed bottom arm. The collapsed bottom arm is just a symptom of a mistake that you've made previous to that point of the vault. So let's look at a particular issue. If you remember, this was the post and we went over a couple different topics. One of them, and you can see it on there, is a flat takeoff. Well, why does a flat takeoff create a collapsed bottom arm? Because you're not jumping up, you're running into the pole, it's gonna look a little bit like the following video. Here's a full speed version of one of my vaulters jumping, and you can see a big collapsed bottom arm, but let's watch it in slow motion. All right, here's that slow motion video of the last jump. And as you can see, he's really backside in his run, and he goes short into takeoff and is very flat, which creates that collapsed bottom arm. And it creates slow pull speed and swing speed. If you only address the collapsed bottom arm and tell him to lock out his bottom arm, you're actually gonna slow down the pull speed and slow down his swing even more. So how do you address it? At Apex, we do jumping drills. There's various ways to incorporate them into training and help improve someone's jumping. Here we have a slow motion version of our most basic jumping drill. This is a four-step jumping drill where people who jump off their left leg, righties, will step back with their right foot, put their right arm forward. The rhythm is gonna be step, step, long, short. So you're gonna see with this drill, it's a normal running stride followed by another normal running stride. Now she's gonna go long for the penultimate step, short, and wow, her hips pop up off the ground, awesome. Once athletes are comfortable with the jumping drill, you can incorporate baby hurdles and add the jump at the end. I'll show you two different athletes doing this drill through the baby hurdles, and we're gonna slow it down in the next two slides. As you can see with this, the athletes now can run through the baby hurdles, working on running form, and then incorporating the jumping drill at the end. You can see her really going for that long short and pop up off the ground. Here's another athlete running through the baby hurdles and doing this jumping drill. Of course, both athletes are at different levels with their running technique and do better and worse jobs of doing that long short. This athlete kind of goes a little bit short. After doing a jumping drill through baby hurdles and the athletes are now more comfortable jumping at speed, you can incorporate it into the pole runs. Here's our two athletes again doing the pole runs with the jump. We're gonna watch it in slow motion and pay close attention to posture. Posture is super important when doing jumping pole runs. Here you can see Sydney does a nice long short, and wow, does she jump up off the ground very tall, and she's not lunging. The reason lunging is bad is if athletes lunge and they lose their posture, they're gonna hit the back of the box really hard and they're gonna collapse that bottom arm. So if you're really trying to prevent that, make sure to tell your kids to stay tall, jump up. You can see Grace has a nice high pole carry. She's dropping the pole now. She's gonna do a nice long short. And wow, nice tall posture. Also something to note, try to get your kids to jump before the pole tip hits the ground. All right, so this is back to the original athlete with that flat takeoff and he collapses his bottom arm. After doing various amounts of jumping drills, let's see what happens with his jump. Here's a three left approach. We'll watch him full speed and then slow mo it, but you can see he jumps up better and way less of a collapse. What's very important to know, don't go right back to your full approach with your biggest pull and your biggest grip. You've gotta lower the resistance, make it a little bit easier so you can actually focus on this technique. So first thing we did was we did some three left approach on a smaller pole, and you can see that long short, he jumps up and he doesn't collapse as much as the video you saw previously because of the jump up. Let's see though now if he could do it at a six left approach. So this is back to that six left approach, and let's see. Much better jump up, much less collapsed. Let's watch it in slow motion. You can see long, short, way better jump up, less of a collapse, and the pole speed and swing speed is much better. So remember, when trying to correct mistakes in the vault, like a collapsed bottom arm, you have to look at the cause. So if takeoff is your issue, make sure to use some of these jumping drills to correct your takeoff, and hopefully you can get rid of that collapsed bottom arm. If you want to contact us, just email us at apexvaulting@gmail.com or reach out through our various sources of social media.